right? Yeah. Oh, we're on. Oh, hey. Well, thanks, Ed. Mike here. I'm on the sideline. We're in Cowboy Stadium, and oh my goodness, this thing is huge. But that's a whole different story. I'm actually here with Bob Gagliano. He's a member of Crossroads Community Church and came out here to Texas with me, and we just wanted to kind of interview and get some thoughts from him. So, Bob, if you could just kind of share, a little bit. We know you had the opportunity to be in the NFL, and kind of give us some of that background.
I'm a little chilly right now. It's a little cold back here.
It is cold.
But it is a beautiful stadium. I played 14 years in the NFL. 49ers, Chargers, Lions, Chiefs, ended up with the Packers, quite a few teams. It's probably an easier question to ask, how many teams did I not play for? but I was fortunate enough to have a good time in the league for a number of years.
Very cool. Question for you would just be, when did you come to faith in Christ? Was that before, after the NFL, during, kind of where did that all fall together?
Well, early in my career, I was raised a Catholic, early in my career, I'd say I was kind of a fence walker. Played on both sides of the fence, and got along with all the heathens of the league, and knew that the Lord had a pull in my heart, and I'm going to get emotional. Anyway, I'd say around 1984, 85, I couldn't ignore the fact that God was real, that Christ really did die for our sins, and about 1984, 85, I made that transition.
What did you notice kind of a difference then in yourself, within maybe the locker room or that influence that you had with other teammates as Christ became really real to you? What did that do with that platform and that influence God had given you?
Some folks, like a Kurt Warner, for instance, he's been able to use the platform with his faith on a pretty large scale. He's been able to reach a lot of folks, and it's a great story, a Kurt Warner story. And other folks, can do that in a smaller way, which is just as important as folks who have a large influence in other people's lives. And if it's just being able to work with a small group in your community, through your church, at work, whatever it is, if you can just have that influence and people want to know what it is that you have, that's something that they want.
Wow, that's really cool, just the opportunity that you had. And, the only team I really heard that you played for was the Niners. Those other ones, I didn't really recognize any of them, but... So for the 49ers, what position did you have the opportunity to play?
I'm not really a big 49er fan. I did play for the 49ers and the Chargers. There might be a Charger fan.
There's a couple, but we're working on it.
I was fortunate. I played quarterback when I was in the league, and it's just one of many positions. I've been knocked down a few times when some of the big guys up front maybe missed a block. Hopefully they didn't do that on purpose. But it brings up the importance of each team member. And just like the church, Jesus Christ is the head coach, and the body of the church is comprised of so many different types of people who bring different gifts to the table. To form this team, it's the same thing with an NFL football team. You got a lot of folks with a lot of different types of talents from different backgrounds who bring different gifts to the game. And if you're not in conjunction with one another, things break down. So it's important for the body to stay together and be on the same page and allow their gifts to come through to form the best team that you possibly can. So it's a great analogy.
Great, thank you. Well, in just a moment, we're going to hear the Bob's Super Bowl prediction for this year. But right before that, please hear a word from our sponsor.
This interview was brought to you in part by HSM, High School Ministries, where we are never too young and we never want to get old.
All right, and we're back here with Bob, and we just wanted to kind of check and see who's going to win today. I mean, we've got Packers, Steelers. What's your...
Chargers! Win the Super Bowl!
Ed, the...
Chargers! Win the Super Bowl!
The Chargers, they're not playing. They're not in the Super Bowl. They haven't been in the Super Bowl for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
No, they're not here today. I'm
all
sorry.
All right. Well, 21 is Tomlinson.
Right.
Go Jets! Win the Super Bowl. Jets are not in the Super Bowl?
The Jets lost. Tomlinson's done.
Who's in the Super Bowl?
It's the Green Bay Packers and the Pittsburgh Steelers are playing today.
Green Bay?
Green Bay, yes.
Go Favre! Win the Super Bowl!
No. Favre retired 12 times ago. And so he's not with the Packers. Yeah. Thanks right. for... Wow. Oh, sorry about that. You probably had to deal with a lot of fans like that over the years, didn't you? Just kind of a little on the edge. And
I'm surprised you guys don't have bodyguards out here.
Yeah, I'll talk to Jerry Jones about that. So, anyway, back to what we were actually talking about. Who's your prediction? Who's going to win the game today?
You know, I just hope it's a good game. I'd say if you look at the Final Four, they all have strong defenses. You win championships with defense. Good weather conditions. I think they're going to close the dome. So I'm going with the Packers and that quarterback and those receiving crew.
Sounds good.
Well, thank you, Bob, for being here, for being available. And for those of you at church, thanks for being here. Have a great day. Back to you, Ed.